Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
You're listening to Radio Lewes, where the music matters, and welcome back to Guess the Year, the Just for Fun music and trivia quiz show. I've got a year full of information and a year full of music, so let's get started. Keep it there, and Hey Stupid with the title track to the album. Now, we're in January, obviously, we're starting the year, and on the 3rd of January, the UK expels all Iraqi diplomats from the country due to the Iraqi government's illegal annexation of Kuwait 5 months previously. On the 5th, 27 people die as a result of gale force winds across Britain. And on the 8th, a train crash at Cannon Street Station in London kills one person and injures over 500 more. On the 16th of January, the final phase of the M40 motorway through Oxfordshire is open, giving the West Midlands conurbation its first direct motorway link with London. On the 17th of January, the Gulf War begins as the Royal Air Force joins Allied aircraft in bombing raids on Iraq. And after those depressing bits of trivia and statistics and things, I think we'll go with some more music. It's a bit more fun.
I'm too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love. Love's going to leave me.
Right, said Fred, of course, and I'm too sexy. It's a terrible affliction, that. On the 7th of February, the Provisional Irish Republican Army launch a mortar attack against 10 Downing Street, blowing in all the windows of the Cabinet Room during a session of the War Cabinet, but there are no injuries. On the 8th of February, heavy snow disrupts the country for the second time during the winter season as Britain experiences a prolonged cold snap. Something that this show would not be possible without. British scientist Tim Berners-Lee introduces World Wide Web, the first web browser, while working at CERN in Geneva, and the first website goes online 7 months later. And Iraq accepts provisional ceasefire on the 28th of February, and British troops halt their advance on Baghdad. This is not a happy year so far. And this isn't a particularly happy song, but it's a good one. Guns N' Roses, of course, with November Rain. And it's still not really a very happy year, especially for the Tories. An Ipsos Mori poll on the 3rd of March shows that John Major is more popular with his voters than his Conservative government. And on the 8th, Ribble Valley, the 10th safest Conservative constituency in Britain, is won by the Liberal Democrats in a by-election. The Birmingham Six on the 14th of March are freed after the Court of Appeal quashes their convictions over the 1974 pub bombings in Birmingham, which killed 21 people and injured more than 160 others. One bit of good news. John Major announced the abolition of the community charge on the 23rd of March, the dreaded poll tax. That one was very popular with an awful lot of people. Now something a little different.
Spinderella cut it up one time. Come on.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Let's talk about sex for now. To the people at home or in the crowd, it keeps coming up anyhow. Don't be coy, avoid, or make void the topic, cause that ain't gonna stop it. Now we talk about sex on the radio and video show.
Many will know.
Anything goes. Let's tell it like it is and how it could be. How it was and of course how it should be. Those who think it's dirty have a choice. Pick up the needle, press pause, or turn the radio off. Will that stop us, Pat?
I doubt it.
All right then, come on, spin.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you.
Make any man's eyes pop. She uses, she got to get whatever she don't got. Fellas droop like fools, but then again, they're only human. The chick was a hit because her body was booming. Gold, pearl, rubies, crazy diamonds. Nothing she wore was ever common. Her dates, heads of state, men of taste, lawyers, doctors. No one was too great for her to get with or even mess with. The press, she says, was next on her list. And believe me, you, it's as good as true. There ain't a man alive that she couldn't get next to. She had it all in the bag. She should have been glad, but she was mad and sad and feeling bad, thinking about the things that she never had. No love, just sex, bottle necks with a check and a note. The last night was dope, 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 dope.
Take it easy.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex.
Come on.
Let's talk about sex.
Gonna play this on the radio.
And why not? Everybody have sex.
I mean, everybody should be making love.
Come on, how many guys you know make
love? Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Let's talk about sex indeed, from Salt and Pepper. On the 4th of April, social services in the Orkney Islands are criticised for their handling of more than 100 children who have been returned to their families after being taken away over allegations of child abuse. On the 8th of April, the Football Association announces plans for a new Super League of 18 clubs to replace the Football League Division 1 as the highest division in English football. The move is attacked by smaller Football League clubs who fear that they could go out of business if TV revenue is confined to the proposed Super League. On the 19th of April, George Kerry is enthroned as the Archbishop of Canterbury. And on the 23rd, the government confirms that the unpopular community charge is to be replaced by a new council tax within 2 years. More music now. REM with Shiny Happy People. We're into May now. On the 6th of May, Arsenal are crowned champions of the Football League. And on the 15th, Manchester United win the European Cup Winners' Cup with a 2-1 win over FC Barcelona in Rotterdam. On the 18th of May, Helen Sharman becomes the first British person in space, flying with the Soyuz TM-12 mission. And Tottenham Hotspur win the FA Cup for a record 8th time with a 2-1 win over Nottingham Forest. Midfielder Paul Gascoigne, multi-million pound transfer target for Italian side Lazio, suffers a cruciate knee ligament damage early in the match and is not expected to play again that year. On the 21st of May, in South Wales, which has some of the worst unemployment rates in Britain, receives a boost when the go-ahead is given for Japanese electrical company Sony to build a new factory in Bridgend that will create 1,400 jobs when it opens in 2 years' time. And on the 22nd of May, nearly 6 months after the breakthrough of the Channel Tunnel service tunnel, the breakthrough in the North Rail Tunnel is achieved. On the same day, road links to the British Terminal are improved when the final section of the M20 motorway is opened between Maidstone and Ashford, meaning that the tunnel's unbroken motorway link with London has already been completed, an estimated 3 years before the first trains move between Britain and France. More music now. This one was controversial at the time, because it wouldn't get any play on the BBC, or even though it hit the top of the charts.
Let her go. Bring your daughter.
Iron Maiden there with Bring Your Daughter to the Slaughter. Maybe I can understand why it wasn't getting any play. June now, and Kia, the Korean car maker, begin importing cars into the UK for the first time. Initially, it will only import the Pride, a rebadged version of the Japanese Mazda 121, but a further model is expected. The National Gallery in London opens its new Sainsbury wing to the public on June the 10th. On the 14th of June, July Ann Gibson becomes the first woman to qualify as a pilot with the Royal Air Force. And on the 25th of June, Nissan, the Japanese car maker with a plant in Sunderland, starts price wars by reducing the cost of its car in order to boost the flagging sales brought on by the recession. And on the 28th, 7 months after her resignation as Prime Minister, Margaret Thatcher announces that she will stand down as a Member of Parliament at the next general election, which has to be held within the next 12 months. And the final breakthrough in the Channel Tunnel is achieved when the last section of clay in the South Rail Tunnel is bored away. More music now, and this is The Farm.
Together.
The Farm with All Together Now. July saw the Vauxhall Belmont Compact Saloon end production, and a new Astor range of hatchbacks and estates begins, with saloon and convertible models arriving later. The Bank of England closes down the Bank of Credit and Commerce International amid fraud allegations on the 5th of July. Several local authorities in the UK lose millions of pounds in investments held in the bank. On the 15th of July, the 17th G7 summit is held in London. On the 16th, a government survey of children's school reading reveals that Roald Dahl, who died 8 months earlier, has now overtaken Enid Blyton as the most popular author of children's books. And on the 17th, the Ultimate Steel Roller Coaster, Europe's longest, opens at Lightwater Valley Theme Park in North Yorkshire. More music.
I love the live and kicking.
That was Mr. Big and Alive and Kicking. Now I'm skipping September because not very much of any interest happened. To tell you that on the 9th of October, the first sumo tournament was held outside Japan and it's hosted at the Royal Albert Hall in London. On the 19th of October, now I remember this and I can only describe it as musical purgatory. If you're a fan of Bryan Adams, I don't apologise. When Everything I Do It For You was at number one for 15 consecutive weeks. Oh, it was painful. It was finally knocked off on the 27th by U2's The Fly. We're going to move on to November because nothing much else happened. Let me see. No, I'm going to play you some more music. Then I'll tell you what's going on in November. There with Suicide Blonde. Okay, we're in November and computer retailer PC World opens its first branch in Croydon. And what else can I tell you? On the 23rd of November, Freddie Mercury, the lead singer of rock band Queen, announces that he is suffering from AIDS following lengthy media speculation about his health. And very sadly, he died the next day in his home in London. just 24 hours after going public. And he was cremated after a funeral service held in West London Crematorium on the 27th of November. On the 28th of November, the first performance of Alan Bennett's play The Madness of George III opened in London. Now some more music with Roxette.
Hello!
Set there with Joyride. And just because it's relevant, on the 27th of November, the government announces that joyriders who are found guilty should face maximum penalty of 5 years imprisonment, as well as unlimited fines and unlimited automatic driving bans. Joyriding has recently surged across Britain, with almost all of those involved being children and teenagers. into December now, and on the 1st of December, thousands of British shops, including retail giants Asda and Tesco, defy trading laws and open their doors on a Sunday in a bid to boost trade that has been badly hit by the ongoing recession. On the 16th of December, Stella Rimington announced as the first female director general of MI5. And on the 23rd, Bohemian Rhapsody returns to the top of the British singles charts after 16 years, with the proceeds from the re-release being donated to the Terence Higgins Trust. We're going to carry on with the music, and I'll tell you about some of the technology and movies you might have enjoyed.
You held it in your hands. I had flashed.
Water Boys, of course, and The Hole of the Moon. Now, I mentioned this one earlier on, and that was Tim Berners-Lee introducing the web browser. And the internet is made available to unrestricted commercial use, and the number of computers on the net reaches 1 million. Linus Torvalds releases the first version of the Linux operating system kernel. The American Galileo spacecraft makes its closest approach to 951 Gaspra, becoming the first probe to visit an asteroid. Microsoft releases MS-DOS 5.0, and genetic engineering produced blue roses. Not sure why. The ice covering the Arctic was measured to have decreased by 2% in the last 10 years, and tropical rainforest shrinks by 1% annually as a result of human activities. Trevor Bayliss invented the clockwork radio, and Jeffrey Mahon and Alan Breed invent the in-car airbag. And the movies you will have been enjoying at this time: Terminator 2, Judgment Day, Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, of course, The Science of the Lambs, Hook, The Addams Family, Sleeping with the Enemy, Father of the Bride, Naked Gun 2.5, The Smell of Fear, Beauty and the Beast, Backdraft, Beethoven, and Thelma and Louise. Now, if you haven't guessed it already, this has been 1991. This has been Guest of the Year. I've been Ben Fuller. Thank you so much for listening. I'm going to leave you with Lenny Kravitz. Till next time. Ta-da.
Radio Lewes. Local. Community webcasting.